I'm Samir Mathur, a landscape architect. I represent a company called Integral Designs. We've been commissioned by Godrej Properties to design their project called Godrej South Estate in Delhi. Delhi is a city of gardens. If you look at Delhi from the skyline, there is a lot of trees, there's a lot of greenery. It is also about baolis, about water streams in the Mughal era, in the pre-Mughal era, and in the colonial era. So there are a lot of gardens associated here. In this project, what we've managed to achieve is a sense of interaction between water, green, people, and the general natural environment. This is a sprawling development. We get maybe about 2.5 acres of green itself. We have water, we have things which are available only to royalty in earlier ages. Now they're available to common people. All this has been combined to create this amazing project for Godrej Properties. In this landscape, Godrej has been able to create this wonderful amalgamation of blues and greens. There are water bodies, streams, swimming pool, amazing kind of experiences for people who are there. In terms of flora, there are zones of different colors. Every color has its own sensation to the user. Through the year, you will get a zone which is purple. You will get a tree which will flower in January. You will get a shrub which will flower during the monsoon. And it will create this ambience of purpleness in that zone. So a user will experience different kinds of flora as they move through the project. Cars dominate the landscape of any housing society. In this case, we managed to segregate cars away from the gardens. As soon as you get out of a car, you are in the garden. And the garden stretches seamlessly under the building. So the space where the building is has a gap. That is called the stilt. Now that stilt is used for a club activity. In the morning, it will be used for yoga. In the afternoon, it will be used for congregating. It will be used for getting together. In the evenings, children will come and play. There will be other activities which will be going on. So this space, the formerly called the stilt, is actually something which will be unique to this project. Walking and jogging are a part of our lives today. They are about fitness, about health. Everybody is interested in it. We have created a variety of experiences for a person who's either walking or jogging. Along the roads, there'll be shaded walkways through trees. In the garden, they'll be walking past water bodies, past trees, past the flora, through beauty. The clubhouse is an interesting blend of the inside-outside experience. There are many facilities in the club. And the best part about the club is the swimming pool. There are cascades, there is a children's play area, a children's pool, there is a jacuzzi, there is splashing water, there are bubblers. This pool will be the heart and soul of this project. You can access the pool 24/7, you will see it, and you will be able to enjoy the pool. Even if you're not swimming, you'll be seeing it, you'll be hearing the sound of water while you're walking past it, while you're jogging, while you're sitting. This is unique to this project. The context is a South Delhi plot. But what we managed to achieve is absence of cars, increase of natural elements, presence of water, beauty and aesthetics, and a harmonious blend of different aspects of living.
Gaurav Sanan. I'm a partner at Urban Architecture Works. We are the architects for Godrej South Estate at Delhi. Working with Godrej has always been a very fulfilling experience. Godrej being a design-led company gives us the freedom to conceptually work on designs. The profits and the numbers are not always pushing the whole product. They also go into the market and come back with surveys of what people actually need. Whenever you're working for Godrej projects, something which we always have to keep in mind is the longevity of the project. We try and pick modern clean lines, straight lines, which are easy to maintain. While we work on the aesthetics of the outside as an architect and the way the building will be presented to the world, the way the people live inside and they feel is extremely important. The spatial quality, what you see from your chair, or you know, what do you view when you're sitting on your dining table? Do you have enough light when you're reading a book? It becomes extremely important. When you design in the city of Delhi, the historical references become very, very important in the whole design process. When you look at residences over the ages, you look at the forts, which had commanding views and fantastic heights. We have that at South Estate. It's going to be one of the tallest buildings in South Delhi. When you look at the fantastic havelis with the merchants lived in, with huge courtyards, we have nice spaces where, you know, elderly people can just sit, talk to each other, you know, be a part of the community. One of the luxurious architectural elements which has actually existed through the times is the stone jali. You know, the jali was used for privacy, the jali was used for shading. It was also used to represent luxury because an artisan actually carved a stone block for you for days to come so that you could put that on your house. We used a lot of large windows, glass windows, and you know, double-heighted lobbies in the whole project. The idea was for the residents to feel probably one with nature. We have these fantastic terraces on top of our buildings. So what they offer you is a private space where you can soak in the sun in the winters, enjoy a barbecue with your friends, and have fantastic views of Tughlakabad Fort. What we want the residents to have is a fantastic arrival experience. So the experience doesn't start when you open up the door to your apartment, but the experience starts when you enter the compound. We have looked at, you know, various buildings like the Rashtrapati Bhavan, we looked at India Gate. Stone has been used in fantastic ways. What we have done at South Estate is that we have these fantastically designed double-height lobbies where you have stone which is not just on the inside, but it clads outside. So overall, the exterior was designed for a person walking on the ground. In any building, any tall building, what is extremely important is how the top looks, because that is what is visible to everybody in the city. While designing South Estate, we used metal jalis, which were illuminated in shades of copper, which gave the whole presence of a crown on top of the building. The best thing about Godrej South Estate are the crown apartments. These spacious apartments command fantastic views, whether it's the Tughlakabad Fort or the Delhi Eye. You know, I would say all these together make Godrej South Estate the landmark to live in.